Hi, Nico. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Yeah. What was the most valuable part of being in the G League bubble for you?
I think the most valuable part for me was just the minutes, the experience, getting to go out there and, you know, just play freely and get a feel for, you know, somewhat the NBA. It's not the exact same, but it's pretty close. But just getting a feel, getting minutes, being able to be out there, make mistakes and learn from them. Really just the minutes was the biggest part for me. I was playing 30 plus a game, just getting back in the flow, getting comfortable. That was really my first time playing a big minutes since March of last year. So that was the biggest thing for me was the minutes and the experience.
Nico, hi, Janie McCauley from AP. Nice to see you back. What does it mean to come up and join this team right now? And you know, you're in a nice rhythm, and to come back and join the Warriors for the second half of this stretch.
It's great. You know, when I got the call, I was super, super excited. I missed the vibe, you know, just seeing the guys every day. We have a great group of guys, staff, players, whoever it is. We just have a really good group. So being around them and just kind of the vibe that the team gives off was missed down in the bubble. And then just being around guys like Draymond and Steph and Andrew and Kelly, guys like that that are veterans that have kind of been in this league and learning from them. So now I'm kind of back to that role where I'm listening a lot more, trying to learn as much as I can, because I know there's guys on this team that have, you know, been around the league for a while.
Were there some things, Nico, that you took from your stretch with Golden State from guys like Draymond and Steph that you applied down there that made you even a better player to now come back?
There's some small things in there just that you learn throughout being with the guys. Draymond texted me a couple times, just gave me some feedback. He was watching some of the games, and he'd send me clips here and there, asking me questions, what I saw, what he saw. So it was more conversation. And I think that's huge when a guy like that, the leader of the team, is reaching out. It really means a lot. And, you know, it's cool to see guys like that are up here, they're still watching, still kind of have your back in a way. So that was cool.
Did it surprise you that they brought you back before the end of the season? Like, were you expecting to go through the playoffs there?
I think the plan was for me to stay the whole G League season. So that's kind of what I was, you know, and anything before that was just kind of extra. That's, you know, it's good to come back early. So I was looking at it like I was going to be there the whole time, just so I wasn't, you know, mad if I didn't come back. But I was just looking at it like I was going to be there the whole time. That was kind of the plan. So when I got the call, it was a little bit of a surprise, a shock. And like I said, I'm super happy to be back.
Do you and Jordan, I guess, combine expect to kind of come back and potentially play a role in the second unit?
No, whatever's asked of me is what I'll do. I'm not expecting anything. I know nothing's given, nothing's handed out. So whatever this team needs, whatever coach wants to do is what I'll be ready for.
Nico, how better?
For the to let you know that you'd be coming back.
Can you repeat that?
Sure. Who was it on the phone that called you, told you were coming back?
Coach Kerr. Yeah, Coach Kerr called me a couple of days ago.
Did he explain, you know, the reasoning behind it?
Just to have me back for these two games. You know, it's a brutal back-to-back. So having as many guys as possible, I think, was kind of the plan. And he kind of just said we're on all-star break after that. They wanted me to get a break as well. And, you know, we end in Phoenix, which is home for me. So I get to stay home for a couple of days as well.
Thanks.
Nico, after the bubble experience, how better player you feel? And you mentioned the minutes that you take in the games in the bubble. How better player you feel? And how big is the confidence for you after that experience?
I mean, I'm very confident right now coming into this. And like I said, I think that was the biggest thing for me, the experience, because it'd been 11 months since I'd played big minutes in a game. It's hard to get into a rhythm and a flow and just practice and workouts. So being able to go down there and play those games was huge for me. And I don't know if I got a lot better, but I feel way more comfortable. So I'm definitely going to be a better player, I think, just because of the comfortability factor. You know, I'm more comfortable on the floor. Just feel like myself again, really.
And what is your expectation?
Like I said earlier, I really don't expect anything. I'll be ready for whatever, just kind of mentally trying to prepare for any situation to come. whatever this team needs, whatever coach wants, it's kind of what I'll be ready for.
Nico, when you talk about the minutes that you played in the bubble, the confidence that you got from that experience, what do you think about the Warriors investing in you and helping you lay that foundation for, you know, a long-term plan for some, for your longevity in the league?
Right. You know, it means a lot, and you could, I could tell that they're bought in with me and they care about me as a player and a person. So that's, to start off, that's really important for me. And then, you know, as a player, especially as a young player, your goal isn't to go to the G League. But they kind of pointed out that it's not a demotion, and it's more in the sense of development. You know, if I can't get minutes here, if I'm not getting minutes here, it's good for me to go down there and just get a feel again. And so that's kind of how I looked at it. I saw it in a positive way. And they kind of helped me see it that way. They were great about it. And like I said, most of the guys, the players, coaching staff, they were all watching and shooting me texts here and there, giving me calls every once in a while and just making sure I was good, telling me what they were seeing. So all in all, it was a really positive experience. And I'm actually really glad I did it. I feel a lot better now than I did before.
I think Jordan was like,
all right, last, go ahead. Last question. Then we got to catch a bus. Go ahead.
Yeah. I think Jordan was like top five in the G League in scoring, somewhere around there. From your perspective, what did you see from him down there?
I mean, he was just being himself. I think that's just who he is. He's aggressive. I think his bag, he has a bag offensively. Like, he can kind of just do anything offensively. He shoots it well, handles it well, and gets to the rim. He's a bigger guard. So playing with him was super fun, and just kind of learning his game more was super fun. But he's a great player. That's just who he is. I don't think it was anything out of the ordinary. I think that's just who he is as a player.
Great. Thank you. Appreciate that.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, everybody. We got to go catch a bus tonight. What, 7 o'clock start? So Coach Kerr will be at 5:30. On with any questions.